So hello everybody, welcome back to another episode. In this one we are looking at the top 5 SPACs, which I will definitely keep my eyes on over the next few days, or at least the next few weeks, because all of these really do have a lot of potential in my opinion. Some of these are really close to the merger, some of these are not so close, some of these are high in price, some of these are relatively cheap, but either way I do see all of these as very big companies which are going onto the market in the next few months, and of course for that reason I have included them all in this video. So of course if it does sound like a good episode, please do leave a like and subscribe. And if you want to see any more on any of these stocks, make sure to just type in N2S Finance and then the name of the stock, because we have made a video on each and every single one of these stocks. So yeah guys, with that being said, we are going to jump straight in and look at our first pick, which is in no particular order. BFT. So of course BFT is one which we have actually made a video on only tonight. This one is called Foley Transamine Acquisitions Corp and actually is merging with a company called Paysafe. Now Paysafe is similar in a way to PayPal. They have an online wallet which you can basically pay money into. It means that you don't have to deal with physical money. Some people don't actually like that for some reason, so fair enough to them, and it is definitely a growing market sector. Either way, the company has been around since like 1997, so it's definitely well established. And of course it looks to be going very strong. In the future I can see it doing very well. I can see this one being worth over $100 in the next year or so, potentially, if we get very lucky with that one. But of course that is a very high end estimate. Either way, I think that if we are looking at this one for the long term, and if you're willing to hold for the next 5 to 10 years, I think you'll be looking at a very decent profit in my opinion. For the next few months, if you wanted to hold, I think we're still looking at a good profit, as we could potentially swing trade this one up until the date of the merger, or at least around that period, and potentially make some money. But of course, by the way guys, you already know that I am not a financial advisor, but I really should say that in every single video. So with that being said, we're going to move straight on to our next pick, which is called ChargePoint, or at least that is who it is merging with. The stock itself is called SBE, or Switchback Energy, and this one is trading at $44. It is one of the more expensive picks on the list. I think it's actually the most expensive, with good reason though. It is definitely a market leader in electric vehicle charging. This company has a lot of different stations all around the world. They have stations here in the United Kingdom, they have stations in America, and they are very, very widespread. I think they already have a very, you know, well-established lead over the other brands, and that really is going to help them in the future when it comes to the stock price and, of course, the company's value going forwards. And I think going into the next 10 years or so, we are going to be seeing extreme growth with this one, as electric cars are the future. They're coming into play more and more, and, you know, subsequently, I do believe you're going to be seeing a big increase in companies like this. Now, like I said, this is definitely a market leader in my opinion, but a second stock which is in a similar position is called NBAC. Now NBAC is called Newborn Acquisitions Corp, and this is in a similar sector, is merging with a company called Nuve, and Nuve is also an electric vehicle charging company, not as well established, and the stock is actually losing a bit of its value over the past month. It's currently sat at about $19, so around the $20 mark, and it looks to be going down right now. Now, either way, I don't think this one is going to be as quick of a grower as ChargePoint, and I think that's safe to say, but in my personal opinion, I definitely still do see it as being a decent buy, as we personally, in my view again, are going to be seeing good growth on this one regardless, leading up until the next 10 years, simply due to the fact that a lot more electric vehicles will be on the streets. Swiftly moving on to our next pick, we have NGA stock, or Northern Genesis Acquisition. Now, this one is trading at $32, and it is going to be merging with Lion Electric. Now, Lion Electric is a very interesting company indeed. They make commercial vehicles in the electric sector, such as school buses and all that kind of good stuff. And for the future, you know what, this is kind of a very big industry, and this stock could potentially be game-changing. So, of course, in the short term, we're looking at a big growth leading up until that merger. I wouldn't be surprised if we sold off for a day or two very soon, and I don't think it's a bad thing at all with that big increase. But overall, we really can see this one starting to pick up some traction, and I think it's a great thing to see. I think leading into the future, we are going to be seeing big gains with this one, and I think for the next 10 years, it could definitely be a good hold. So moving on to our next and final pick, we have APXT. Now, of course, this one is merging with AvePoint stock, and it is going to actually create an online cybersecurity stock. So, of course, this company operates in data management, protection, and also cloud storage for Microsoft 365. It's a very widespread service, so, of course, it is a very big industry. If we look at the competitors, we have companies like Snowflake, which is, of course, a very high-valued stock, and subsequently, we could be seeing big gains on this one. But leading into the future with this one. The merger is apparently going ahead on the 28th of February, and of course that gives us enough time to get a big gain with the with the share price. I think subsequently we could be looking at some big increases in the next month when it comes to this stock. So of course that does conclude the video. I hope you enjoyed all of the picks. If you did, please do leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye until then.